We are in Southeast DC. This is Alger Park, and it's part of the Texas Avenue tributary, which ultimately drains to the Anacostia. Here we have a very dramatic example of the impacts of uncontrolled stormwater. In Southeast DC, we have these Christiana soils, which are predominantly sand. When uncontrolled stormwater hits this sand, it just blows it out. And all this sediment is gonna end up down in the Anacostia and eventually likely down in the bay, which is not what we want.
My name is Stephen Reiling. I'm an environmental protection specialist with the District of Columbia Department of the Environment. So this technique is called regenerator stormwater conveyance. And the regenerative part of it is that over time, this will just get better. The vegetation will come back. We have all these plantings that will mature. And the conveyance part of it, as you can see, it's a series of step pools, weirs, these cobble weirs, step pool weir. We just have a way of slowing the stormwater down, letting it settle, let the sediment settle in these pools. And these ponds, they act to slow the water down. They also act to infiltrate the water back into the ground. And then also, obviously, by looking at it, you can see it's great habitat for wildlife. So that's one of the other goals is habitat creation. Total cost for this project here is close to $700,000. And impressively, it only took actual construction less than 3 months to do the bulk of the construction. Then plantings have been sort of sporadic as needed. This tributary, which is Milk House Ford, this will make its way into Rock Creek, which is maybe a mile downstream, and eventually into the Potomac and then the bay. So if we can stem the problems here at the headwaters, that's the best place to do it. We have a very impervious watershed up here, and so there's grease and oil from vehicles, sediment, any kind of fertilizers that are coming off the lawns. And so we'd like to slow that down and hopefully keep it here before it makes its way to the bay.
We're in Watts Branch, which is Northeast DC. This stream had a history of sewer leaks, a lot of trash, a lot of dumping, not a lot of biological life, and just a very, very poor quality stream. This is what you might call a traditional natural channel design. These stream restoration structures are designed to deal with high flows and to keep the channel relatively stable. During low flow, like what we have right now, water flows through here. It's possible for fish to pass through. When we have a storm, what will happen essentially is the water will rise up here. As it comes over here, due to the grading, it will tend to fall back into the center of the stream. So essentially the drop of water comes up here and then it's going to fall in this way over these stones, as opposed to coming in and tearing out this bank. This is a bandalong litter trap, and these basically float on top of the stream, and the trash that comes down from upstream will get caught in these structures. And we're doing it because we really want people to value the stream, and we know that people's impression, litter, and just general appearance really impacts people's thoughts and their ideas about what their local water bodies are. There's a lot of work to do in the district in terms of stream restoration. We restored three in the last year, in 2011. We have four other stream projects in design, and we think we can make a real positive impact on the Anacostia and the bay overall. It's going to take some time and some money, but we're well on our way, and we expect to do many more.